In this lesson, we're going to talk about the converse of the Pythagorean theorem. Converse is kind of like saying the opposite of. And so what we've seen before is that we use the Pythagorean theorem, we know something is a right triangle, and we use it to solve for the missing side. Well, what the converse is doing is it tests the triangle to prove whether or not it really is a right triangle. So this is what the converse says. It says, if a right triangle has side lengths of A, B, and C, right? We know the side lengths are called A, B, and C, such that the area of the square of side A plus the area of the square of side B is equal to the area of the square of side C, then the triangle is a right triangle. So when we look at this, we're actually going to be given all of the side lengths. So it's just saying that if A squared plus B squared truly equals C squared, then it is a right triangle. Okay? So remember, in a right triangle, the longest side is called the what? It's called the hypotenuse. That's important because we have to know which side to call side C. Okay, so it says label the sides of the triangle with A, B, and C. Okay, so I would start out by finding my right angle. Here is your right angle. Hopefully you recognize that. So that means side 5 and side 7, since they make up the right angle, those are the legs. So we could say that A is 5. And B is 7. Remember, it would be okay if you switch those up. And then side C would be 9. We know that side C is 9 because, again, it is the longest side. So now it says set up an equation and determine if it's true. So we're looking to see if our equation makes a true statement. Okay, so we said that A was 5, so 5 squared plus 7 squared is equal to 9 squared. So all I did was fill it in. So let's test it. 5 squared is 25, 7 squared is 49, 9 squared is 81. Okay? So let's check. What is 25 plus 49? That is 74. Well, 74 is not equal, that's what this means, not equal to 81. Therefore, the triangle is not a right triangle. So that didn't work. It didn't come out to be equal. So we did this. These sides do not form a right triangle. It looks like it, but looks can be deceiving, right? Okay, so let's look at the next example. Let's label our sides. Here would be my right angle. This is my longest side, so it has to be C. That means this would be A and B. So 8, A is equal to 8, B is equal to 15, C is equal to 17. Okay, so let's set up our equation. Set up an equation to determine if it's true, if it truly forms a right triangle. So 8 squared plus 15 squared equals 17 squared. So square those numbers with your calculator real quick. Check them out. Make sure you know how to use your buttons on your calculator. This would be 64 plus 225. Check me because I'm not using my calculator right now. 17 squared is 289. Okay, so let's test that. Does that add up? What does that add up to? It adds up to 289. So let's prove it. 289 is equal to 289. Therefore, the triangle is a right triangle. And so that's it. That's exactly how we prove or use the Pythagorean theorem's converse to determine if it's a right triangle.